Hello friends, in this lecture we will discuss about cardiac cycle. Okay, so cardiac cycle is a very important and a very basic part of cardiovascular system. If you want to understand the other topics like understanding the murmur or understanding the JVP, jugular venous pressure, or understanding the heart sounds, it is very important first to know about the cardiac cycle. So one cardiac cycle is consist of one systole and one diastole. Okay, so before discussing the cardiac cycle, we will discuss about the blood circulation in the heart. So blood circulation you may be already knowing, but we will revise it in short. Okay, so this is right atria and right ventricle. And this one is a left atria and left ventricle. Okay. So, right atria and right ventricle, they are separated by a tricuspid wall, and left atria, left ventricle, they are separated by a bicuspid wall, that is mitral wall, and from left ventricle arises aorta, and from right ventricle arises pulmonary artery. Okay, and there are cuffs in these arteries too. In aorta we have a semilunar wall, that is aortic semilunar wall, while in pulmonary artery again there is a semilunar wall, that is called as pulmonary semilunar wall. Okay, then there are two vessels which drains in atria. These are SVC, that is superior vena cava, and IVC, that is the inferior vena cava. Okay, and in the left atria again four vessels they open. These are four pulmonary veins. Okay, four pulmonary veins. So now heart will contract and it will relax. So both atria contracts, that is called as atrial systole, and when the ventricle contracts, that is called as ventricular systole, and when they relax, that is called as diastole. Okay, so let us see what happens here in the heart. Initially, let us consider a condition where the ventricle is in full diastole. Ventricle is in full diastole and there is a blood here inside the ventricle. It has received the blood from atria. Okay, now the ventricle is completely relaxed. It is filled with blood. Okay, then what happens? Ventricle will contract. Once the ventricle contracts, blood from the ventricle will be ejected into the aorta. Okay, so blood from left ventricle will go to the aorta. Okay, this is a oxygenated blood or pure blood. Okay, oxygenated, then aorta will carry this blood to whole of the body. Okay, there are branches, it will carry to upper body as well as the lower body, and then this aorta will divides into arteries, then arterioles, then capillaries. Okay, so aorta will divide into arteries, then arterioles. This is just a pictorial representation, then capillaries. Okay, and then at the level of capillaries, gaseous exchange take place. Means what? Oxygen from inside the capillary will move to outside to the tissue, and carbon dioxide will move into the capillaries. So this CO2 will move into the capillaries. So this oxygenated blood will become deoxygenated, and these capillary will join to from venules, they will join to from veins, and then ultimately they will drain into the right atria through SVC, that is IVC and SVC. SVC will drain the blood from upper extremity and face, while IVC will drain the blood from lower extremity and the abdomen. And this deoxygenated blood will come to the right atria. Okay, from right atria, blood will go to right ventricle. Once this AV wall open, blood from atria will go to the ventricle, and then ventricle will contract and blood will go to pulmonary artery. This pulmonary artery will divide into its two branches, right and left, and then they will go to lung. Here the pulmonary artery will subdivide, and ultimately it will form capillary network. Okay, so this is going to the lung. From right branch will go to the right lung, left pulmonary branch will supply the blood to the left side of the lung, and again they will subdivide, and there will be arterioles and capillaries. So pulmonary artery is divided into arterioles and ultimately capillaries, and at the level of capillaries, the reverse gaseous exchange will take place. Reverse gaseous exchange means CO2 will move out and oxygen will move in. So blood is purified. Okay, and these capillary, they will join to form venules, and ultimately they will form four pulmonary veins, and oxygenated blood will be delivered here into the left atria. Okay, so from right ventricle, blood has gone to lungs. In the lung, blood is purified. It is oxygenated, CO2 is moved out, then CO2 is exhaled. And as you inhale, the oxygen goes in, and then oxygen ultimately go into the blood, and then it's returned to the left atria. From left atria, it will go to the left ventricle, and that cycle will be repeated. Okay, so that is the blood circulation. So now we will discuss the cardiac cycle. Okay, now we have to pay some attention, because it is important. Cardiac cycle is important. So let us see what happens. This cardiac cycle has two phases. One is a systole, that is contraction. Another is a diastole, that is relaxation. And it is separate for atria and the ventricle. So there is an atrial systole and atrial diastole, and there is a ventricular systole and ventricular diastole. Okay, so what is the duration of cardiac cycle? This is the one question most of the students they will answer. What is the duration of cardiac cycle? Considering heart rate to be 72 beats per minute, the cardiac cycle duration is 0.8 second. Okay, so in an ideal situation, when the heart rate is 72 beats per minute, okay, means in 1 minute there are 72 beats. So how much time is taking for one beat? It is 60/72, that is approximately 0.8. So this is a normal duration of cardiac cycle. Suppose if heart rate is 60 per minute, then what will be the duration of cardiac cycle? 60 per minute, 60 beats in 1 minute, then duration of cardiac cycle will be 1 second. So the cardiac cycle duration will vary with the heart rate. Okay, when heart rate is high, the cardiac cycle will be shortened. When the heart rate is low, bradycardia, the cardiac cycle will widen. The duration of cardiac cycle will widen. Okay, so we will just consider this condition with heart rate of 72 minutes and the duration of cardiac cycle is 0.8 second. So in 0.8 second, heart or the ventricle will contract and relax, as well as the atria will contract and relax in that 0.1 seconds. Okay, now we will see how, what are the events that occurs in cardiac cycle.